Hey everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to update data in MongoDB database by using Spring Boot. So let's get started. So if you want to watch the entire tutorial on how to connect Spring Boot with MongoDB database as well as post data, you can just click on the card that is appearing on top, because in this video I'm going to show you only the update operation. So before that, let me explain you the code. So here I'm having my class which is named student. I'm having three variables: roll number, name and address, and this is going to be my repository related to my class student, and final thing is going to be the controller. And I'm not having here any service. If you want, you can just have it. So this update operation is going to be exactly similar to the post operation. We'll be sending the name, roll number and address from our postman as a body, so we'll be using the request body annotation similar to post. So let me just copy the post function and paste it over here. So first thing, this is not going to be post mapping. The annotation is going to be put mapping, which is going to be update. So I need to have here put mapping. And next, just change the path to update student. Also copy this and change the function to update student also. And this is going to be fine. Request body is going to be student. And this is also going to be of type student, because we are going to send name, roll number and address. So we have all the three data members of object. So this is fine. So in this, we will be performing three simple operations. The first one is fetch the object using ID. So by ID, I meant the roll number over here. And another important thing is that if I go to my class, here I will be having the ID annotation. It is really important to have this ID annotation, because I'll be using find by ID. So that function works only if you have this ID annotation to your primary key or the primary data member. So roll number is a primary key. It's going to be unique for all the students. So you need to have the ID annotation over there. That's the first thing. So now let's just go and code the first step. Okay. So for this, we will be returning the object. So for example, imagine I'm sending here 5. Okay. So we will be getting this object, this entire object as a value stored in a variable. So we'll be getting this entire object if I pass 5 from postman. So it's going to be of type student, okay, because the object is going to be of class student. So it's going to be student data, anything, you can just literally name anything. I will just go with this equal to. So we will be making use of the student repo, which is the repository object. So in Spring Boot, we can access data from a table with the help of a repository object. So this is my repository and this is my repository object. You need to have it auto wired. So it's going to be student repo dot find by ID. So as I told you, find by ID. So for this, we need to have the annotation ID over here. And inside this, we need to pass this roll number. Okay. So this roll number will be stored in this object. So it's going to be student dot get roll number. All right. And another thing is that we need to have dot or else null. Okay. So the reason why we are having this or else condition is that here we are sending 5. Okay. And 5 is present in our database. There is ID named 5. So what if I send some random number 100 or 1000? That won't be present in our table, right? So in that case, our data value will be assigned with null. That's the reason why we are having this condition over here. And in case the roll number is present in our table, this object, this ID, name and address will be getting stored in this data. So if you want, I can just, you know, print this and show you system.out print. Just go with data. Let me just run this. And in the time, we can just set our path. So it's going to be put or update. Let me just copy this path, paste it. It's going to be update student. And next, we need to go to body. We need to change this to raw. Make sure that you're changing this to JSON and just copy this path and paste it over here. And the reason why I am not putting roll number within double quotes is because I have given the roll number as an integer. So in case if you have a string, you can just, you know, place it as string. So now this is the code. We'll be just printing this object. So we will be getting this data. So if I just go to postman, if I send it, I'm getting 200. And if I go to my console, here you can see roll number 5, the name and address. This corresponds to this one, this entire object. If I pass the roll number as 3, I'll be getting this entire object in the console. So this is basically the thing over there. So now we are good. Next is we need to check if it is null. So for that we'll be just having a if condition. If data not equal to null, only if this data is not equal to null, we'll be performing the update operation. Okay, because else there is no point in performing update, right? If the data is not at all here, we should be perform the update operation. And inside this, we need to update with the requested data. So it's going to be something like this. Data, this object, this temporary object that we are having, dot set name, and we are passing the name from Postman, right? So that's going to be stored in this object, the student. It's going to be student dot get name. So we are getting the name over here and setting to this data. So this data that we set over here will be getting stored in our collection. So that's the thing. We are fetching data from the student. This get name thing is going to be this name. All right. So that's the fact there. And same thing applies for address also. Data dot set address student dot get address. So same, exactly same thing. We are getting this address from this variable student, and we are just storing it inside data. And final thing is we need to save this. Okay, we are just, you know, updating now. We need to save it. So it's going to be same thing, our repository object dot save. It's going to be data. That's it. So let me just now rerun this, and let me just, you know, have 5, or let me go with 1 maybe. I'll go with 1, and I will just have some random alphabet like this. Yeah, W, and clear this, and I'll just send it. Yeah, I'm getting status as 200 because this is void. We are not sending anything. It's just going to be a void over here. This is the console. This is the old data. Okay, this is the old data. So if I just now go to my compass, and if I just refresh this, we are passed the roll number as 1. So this thing needs to be changed to W. Basically, we need to have WWW there. Refresh it. Here you can see I'm having W. So this 2 keys have been updated. So this is basically how you update your data in MongoDB database with the help of Spring Boot. I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I run a lot of videos in crypto operations using Node.js, MongoDB, MySQL, as well as programming videos and other AI related videos. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.